Myasthenia gravis is a relatively common autoimmune disorder that mainly affects muscles under your voluntary control, causing fluctuating muscular weakness and rapid fatigue. Normally, our voluntary muscles need an intact connection with nervous system to contract and produce movement. This intact connection is so-called neuromuscular junction or motor endplate. At neuromuscular junction, neuronal cells release a specific chemical called acetylcholine, which binds to its receptors on muscle membrane, signaling muscle fibers to contract and produce movement. This allows you to normally walk, run, and do exercise. In myasthenia gravis, autoantibodies against acetylcholine receptors break down the normal connection between nerve cells and muscles. The outcome is weakness and fatigue in voluntary muscles, especially facial and eye ones. Drooping eyelids and double vision are often the earliest symptoms. It can occur at any age, but tends to affect girls aged 10 to 30 years. There is no definite cure for myasthenia gravis, making the disease a lifelong condition. But there is a relatively benign and easy-to-cure condition that may be mistaken for myasthenia gravis. Like myasthenia gravis, Graves' disease is an autoimmune condition involving the thyroid gland. In this disease, autoreactive antibodies bind to thyroid receptors, stimulating thyroid gland to overproduce thyroid hormones. This leads to high levels of thyroid hormones, being so-called hyperthyroidism. Besides, autoantibodies attack orbital fibroblasts, causing enlargement of extraocular muscles and inflammation in tissue surrounding the eyes. This condition is known as thyroid ophthalmopathy, mimicking ocular manifestations of myasthenia gravis. With thyroid ophthalmopathy, patients develop diplopia or double vision, a common symptom in myasthenia gravis as well. Unlike myasthenia gravis, patients with Graves ophthalmopathy do not develop ptosis. Instead, they experience protrusion of eyeballs known as proptosis and eyelid retraction, being absent in myasthenia gravis. These differences between thyroid ophthalmopathy and myasthenia gravis are helpful to distinguish these two conditions from each other. In contrast to myasthenia gravis, thyroid ophthalmopathy is not lifelong, and often fades away by itself. The inflamed period tends to last months to at most 2 years. Thanks for your watching. Please let me know the pediatric issues you are willing to learn. Write them in the comments for me. Farewell.